Great morning, dear students. So, as we have finished our explanation of the lesson Father's Help, so today we shall be discussing the question answers, okay, given at the end of your lesson. Now, let's read the question and then see the answer. The first question: what were Swami's feeling on Monday morning? Why do you think he felt so? So, what was his feeling on Monday morning? He was not feeling good in the sense that he has to go to the school. He did not want to go to the school. That is why he pretended to have a headache. He told his mother that he is having a headache and so that he may be excused from going to the school. So that is the answer of the second part of the question. Why do you think he felt so? Because it was Monday morning, and again after the holiday of Saturday and Sunday, the weekend holidays, he again has to go to the school. So we can conclude here that he did not like to attend the school. So that is the reason he is feeling so sick. He is pretending to be sick and he doesn't want to attend the school. Now let's see the next question. How did Swami convince his mother to let him stay at home? How did he convince his mother? As I told you, mothers are very generous, very kind hearted, okay, so they can immediately fall into your traps. If you say that I am not feeling well or I have this thing or that thing, they cannot bear this at all, okay. So they are very soft hearted. So same was with the Swami's mother also. As she came to know that he is having a headache, what did Swami tell his mother? That I am having a headache, so I should be excused not to go to the school. So what did she suggest? That if you are not feeling well to walk to the school, you may take jutka. Jutka is what? A horse drawn carriage, okay. So he was advised that, but then he said that it would increase my headache, so he was again excused. Then his mother asked, do you have any important class? His mother said, then Swami said that he is having his maths class, which is going on like this, and geography, that is going on for the years and years. So he convinced his mother to let him stay at home, as he is not having any important class also. Now let's go to the third question. What did Swami tell his father about Samuel? Why did he do so? So what did Swami say? As he was excused by his mother that you may stay at home, he immediately lie down again. So when his father came and he saw Swami is lying on the bed, he is not still ready for the school. So he got very angry on Swami that why are you not ready till now? So he said what? That I am not feeling well and I am being excused by my mother, allowed by mother to stay back at home. But then father grew very angry. What did he say to Swami? If you are going to waste your time like this, loaf around, roam around on Saturdays and Sundays, so it is very obvious that you are going to have a headache. I will be not listening to any of your excuse and you have to go to the school. And I'm listening to this. What did Swami say? I am already late for the school. If I go late for the school, what is going to happen? Teacher is going to punish me. And then he describes, he gives the lurid account of his teacher Samuel. Okay, what did he say about the Samuel? That he's a very violent teacher, very cruel person who beats the children like anything till he sees the blood on their hand and asks them to smear the blood on the child's face. So he was thinking that if I give such and such details regarding the teacher, what would my father say to me? Okay, if your teacher is so horrifying, if he is so strict, okay, he is so violent, so it is not needed to for you to go to school. But instead what happened, his father was like, then I want to see what kind of teacher is he, what he can do. So he sent him forcefully to the school. So what is my third question answer? Why did Swami say to, in order to escape from the school, that he might be excused by his father, that he will be not allowing his son to go to the school if he is going to be punished so severely? Okay, why did he do so? That is the answer. He wanted to give a false impression, negative impression of the teacher. teacher so that he may be allowed to stay back home. But instead, what happened? It was come on his own. Okay, it took a negative turn. Okay, it was like a U-turn. It came on him only. He fell into his own trap. Now, let's go to the fourth question. Father's behavior on learning about Samuel took an unexpected turn. How did he react? That is the answer of the fourth question. How did he react? What did Swami expect when he was giving the false impression of Samuel to his father? He was expecting that his father would excuse him not to go to the school. But to his surprise, how did his father react? His father took it as a challenge that I want to see what a teacher can do to you. What a teacher like Samuel can do to my child if he goes late to the class. So he took it as a challenge and purposefully sent Swami late to the class. How did he react? He was very angry that how can a teacher be so cruel with a child. Okay. Now, next question. Why was Swami reluctant to give the letter to the headmaster? Reluctant here means not willing. He was not wishing to give the letter to the headmaster. The reason was simple that whatever he said about this teacher Samuel, he was not sure himself that whether he said it correct or wrong. Okay, so he did not know about that. So he was pretending, he was just recalling the memories, okay, where he has the violent nature of Samuel, but he could not recall any. He could not recall any of the negative impression of Samuel. Instead, what did he recall? That Samuel has been sometimes very friendly and cracking jokes on Swami. Okay, so that is why he did not want to give the letter to the headmaster. He thought that if I am going to give this letter, what could be the reaction of the headmaster? He may throw him out of the job as well as he may hand him over to the police. Okay. Now, let's see the sixth question. What did Swami plan to disobey Samuel? Why was Swami disobeying? Disobeying means not following and showing rudeness to the teacher. He thought that he has to give the letter. It was compulsion for him to give the letter to the headmaster as he was scared of his father. He knew that if he did not deliver the letter, father is not going to leave him. So, in order to prove that whatever is written in the letter, whatever he told his father about Samuel, all those things were true. Okay, Samuel was exactly like that person. So, for that reason, he started annoying his teacher Samuel, irritating his teacher. And in return, he was expecting to get nicely from him so that he can have some proof, the marks of the beating or the blood or something like that, so that he can prove to the headmaster that yes, actually he was like that. Now, next question. But today Samuel appeared to have developed more tolerance and gentleness. Why did Swami feel so? So now what happened? As expected, when he told his father about Samuel, he was not expecting his father to react in this way, but he fell into his own trap, and it happened the second time also. How? When he expected Samuel to be very rude to him, okay, for going late to the class, for not showing the homework, but what did in return he got? But he was behaving very tolerant and gently. Okay, he was very gentle towards Swami, asking his well-being, excused him for not doing the homework, did not say anything. In that class also, if he gave any punishment to any other student, they were allowed to sit down within 2 minutes. Okay, so he thought that how is this possible? How is Samuel so calm and relaxed, and how is he so good towards the student today? So that's what the difference what he has observed. But because whatever he has told, the way he has told about the Samuel, it was completely opposite what Samuel was behaving on that particular day. Now, let's read further the eighth question. How did Swami convince himself about giving the master. How did he convince himself? By getting the sticks finally from the teacher Samuel. In the last period, he irritated his teacher so much that ultimately, for disobeying, for not listening, for behaving properly, misbehaving, he got the sticks, and then he was like convinced, he was satisfied that whatever I have told about him was exactly correct. Okay, and that is why now I can give this letter to the headmaster. Now, the last question. Why did Swami not deliver the letter? The most important question. Why did he not deliver the letter to the headmaster? What was the reason? The reason was simple, that headmaster was not there in the cabin. And when he was asked to deliver the letter to the assistant headmaster, the peon informed him that the headmaster is out for 1 week. So he has to deliver the letter to assistant headmaster. So when he asked who is the assistant headmaster, he was told that Samuel was his headmaster, assistant headmaster. So how could Swami deliver a letter of complaint against Samuel to Samuel himself? Okay, can he do so? Will you have this much of courage? No. Okay, so similarly, he did not have that much courage to give the letter of complaint against that person, to that person itself. Okay, so here he just ran away from the place. As soon as he came to know that Samuel is his assistant headmaster, so he did not give the letter, did not say anything, but he instead ran away from the place. So these question answers you have to write on your own. And there is one more exercise down, that is giving the meanings. Okay, some descriptions are given here, okay, and you are supposed to write the meanings. So you have to try this on your own. Answers also you write, and try this also on. If any difficulty, I will be sending you the PDF, the answers. You can first try yourself and then see the answers and write. Okay, and then we have a writing section also in this. Writing section, we will do it later in our grammar topic. When I am going to take the grammar classes, in that class I am going to cover the writing section part. So this is your work for today. Thank you. God bless you all.